Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and very good morning to all in this video. Yes, the result has come down yesterday itself, but I thought posting this morning, I think it would be beneficial for many of those friends who are waiting to see how has the result has performed. Yes, utterly bad, worst performance. Each and every word you can say, the profit has declined 90%, the revenue has declined 40%. You can say like anything. But friends, I personally hope within the period of 1 to 1.5 years, I mean 1.5 years, I see Trident Limited in double digits. Yes, we are extending our target range. We are extending our target range to double digit. It can be 10 or 11 also. But what are the key factors that is required in order to make this share into a double digit, and how is the result performance for this quarter? We are going to analyze it, friends. And if you have been new to this channel, then make sure you please click the subscribe button so that you could get our latest updates regarding mini shares as well as about Trident Limited. So basically, linen cloths, chemicals, belt linen, paper. Actually, if you compare one thing, the Terry Towels, it is comparing with Alok Industries Limited, because Alok Industries also in the same, related to the same segment of Trident Limited. Now this result is about Trident Limited. They are saying that this is the largest player in terms of Terry Towel capacity and one of the largest player in home textile space in India. And they have given this 65% comes from bath and bed linen, 17% from yarn and 18% from paper and chemical industry. Okay, and this is the first thing they want to give it. And one of the main factors why they have increased their portion of bath and bed linen is that in this type of market, chaotic market, in these situations, the bath and bed linen market has risen 37% for Trident Limited, and that is the main good news that one should note here. Okay, and let us move to the financials. Okay, and they given the total income, okay, has reduced 46%, PBT has reduced 93%, and EBITDA has reduced 60%, PAT reduced 92%, and EBIT reduced 83%. So overall, uttermost disappointing quarter. But what made to me say that this could turn into a multi-bagger is that the reasons are going to contribute to you a lot. As you can see here, exports contributed to 74% of the total revenue for the quarter. Okay, and one more thing, the bed linen, I said this one, 37% increase in quarter on quarter, and the finance cost has been reduced. And one more thing for this whole year, right? As on June 30, 2020, the net debt is 1245 crore, and this is a main important point of view you should note. Totally for this year, they have paid around 226 crore of repayment of debt. What it implies, I'm gonna say, okay. First, you have seen the first point, export, and second thing, what you have seen, they have reduced their debt. So if you see, friends, from March 18 to June 20, from March 18 to June 20, the debt has been reduced from 2621 crores to 1245 crores, almost 1100 crores of reduction in debt within a period of 1 year. And that is possible by, you don't want to compile this calculation based on one quarter. That is a mistake. But some companies, even they don't have this bright future, they are trading to premium to its book value, like Inox Leisure, PVR, Indigo, and IRCTC. I mean, this kind of stocks are been trading like hell, but people are not utilizing the capacity that Trident Limited can do, for instance. That is what I want to say about it. And one of the things, this is about the PL saving that they are given. But if one of the things you note here, the dividend payout ratio in financial year 17, it was 15%. Now it has come up to 36% for the previous year. Okay, you could excuse this 1 year for this COVID pandemic on which and everything. But if you notice how the dividend payer ratio has increased, and that is a main important point of view that you should consider. Having a face value of rupees 1 and paying a dividend of 36 paise, what share can pay, which share can pay, I don't know, but it should have a good fundamental basics and things, because just because of paying in one quarter 36 paise does not mean. But if you see, they are trying to improve their dividend payout ratio. I think it is in the verge of breakout, but people are not understanding it, and that is what hurts me a light lot. Okay, and one more thing, friends, if you notice, the sales has reduced down, and the EBIT has reduced down, travel has reduced down. I mean, it is a total overall reduction in here, and they are speaking about this paper business and all. So totally, if you see the financial terms, it has been a drop out quarter for this year. I think it could say a full washout, you could also say like that. But what helps me is that the net to net debt is 0.4 times, that is what. And if you notice, the capital employed has been reduced and fixed assets has been reduced, but at a long term perspective view, I think it's going to be very, very important. So you see the credit rating AA minus and A rating 1, and all in the terms of A plus 1. So I think it is a performance that has been made by Trident Limited in this quarter. But friends, whatever may I say this, Monday, I mean, for the you could see for the next 1 week, there could be a pricing pressure in Trident Limited. Definite pricing pressure will come for Trident Limited. Maybe you can slide down up to 4.5 rupees also, if the market does not understand what is capable of, or rather if the market understand what it is capable of, or what market expects better than what we can, then we can expect a rally up to 7.25 also, to 7.5 also. If these things are very planned correctly, the dividend pay ratios increase properly. And why I said the export things, if you notice, China, India, both are very well in exporting cloth. Now the world hates clothing. Major of the exports goes to Europe and America, right? If the American and European starts to hate these Chinese textiles, then who is back? India's back. Why? Low cost. What is the benefit? More sales for India and less sales for China. That is, Indian companies could get benefited a lot. And how can I say this, if you ask me, friends? Simple. I mean, they have started to ban Chinese. But if you notice, in UK they have banned this Huawei, and in they have banned in US also. I think many things are changing in the market. It is a sunrise sector for textile industries. So the next 1.5 years or 2 years, if this company try to plans and try to increase its capex and its progressions, then it could turn out be a very, very multi-bagger. If things plays out correctly, if I told these things, say the export, if this plays on correctly, then we can see a target of rupees 10. If that is not the case, if it generates normal profit over the year, or an extended dividend payout, and it reduces its debt, then we can see a target of 8.40 to 9.12. I am not changing in the target. I am not changing in this long term view. These ups and downs may come because all of us know what is the reality of this nature right now. So there is no another way. I think it's trading to its par to its book value. I think that is what is important. It is not trading at a premium valuation. It is trading underrated only. So I think there's no much problem for this share. I think a steep discount or a steep debt down or a steep price down could be a beautiful buying opportunity for each and every investor. We would intimate surely for our friends. Whether this result is justified, no. But whether this result is justified, the price trading in the market, absolutely yes. If it reduces down, buying opportunity. If it increases, part exit and partial holding. And that is what about Trident Limited, friends. I hope I haven't just, if in this video till now, then make sure you please click the subscribe button, as well as you share this video to your friends, so that all could get an idea about Trident Limited. Thank you, friends, and I see you in another video very soon.